Every thought you have either moves you away from awareness or closer to it. Away from awareness is towards the realm of beliefs, concepts, things, actions, people. In other words, it moves you toward the external. These thoughts are thoughts about the external world, about circumstances, events, people, things, past, future. It's always about the world around you, the world you see and hear and sense. But there's another type of thought that moves back towards the center of who you really are. And if you've done the self-inquiry exercises in lesson 2, then you should understand this place of awareness. It's this place of being the watcher of the movie rather than the actor in the movie. So you should understand that a little bit by now. But what I found is that the happiest people on earth have created the habit somehow of thinking what I call transcendental types of thoughts. Unhappy people, people that are struggling in life or they're stressed, you're stressed because you're thinking dense types of thoughts. Dense thoughts focus primarily on the focus primarily outwards, as I said, and they use the external world to justify and reinforce what they believe or that position. So for an example, I'm justified in my anger because they did this to me. They did this to me, so they deserve my anger. So my anger is justified. So that's a dense perspective that keeps the anger alive rather than getting rid of the anger. Because you feel justified in it because of something external, then you will continue to repeat that pattern and you will continue to find things to be angry about in your world. So that's a dense perspective. Dense thoughts focus primarily on the past or the future and what is not rather than on what is. So dense thoughts are focused on lack. They're focused on what's missing in my life. What's not here, you know? I don't have enough money. I don't have enough friends. I don't have enough approval from this person. I don't have what I want. So dense thoughts are focused on what is lacking. And they're focused usually on past or future, feeling resentful or regretful about something in the past, or feeling anxious and worried about something in the future. So these are dense perspectives. So transcendental thoughts, as you might be able to guess by now, are focused primarily inwards, towards the source of the emotional upset, and they take responsibility and accountability for it rather than blaming. So a dense or a transcendental perspective on anger might be, I'm angry because I'm full of anger. So you're not blaming the person. The person may have triggered some anger, but you're recognizing that the anger is within me. That's why I'm experiencing it. So it's a more honest position. I'm not angry because of them. I'm angry because I'm full of anger. So it's taking responsibility, and that's taking our power back, giving us the option to choose a new direction and choose a new emotion or to release that anger, right? But if you're justifying the anger, then you're never going to get rid of it because you're thinking it's okay. You're thinking it's the only rational way to be. Of course I'm angry. Why shouldn't I be angry? You're not seeing the other option. You're not seeing the benefit of releasing the anger, and you can't release the anger as long as you don't take responsibility for it, right? So transcendental thoughts, unlike dense thoughts, focus on the present moment. They focus on what is, not on what is not. So by focusing on what is, you make it more likely to feel things like appreciation, gratitude, and compassion. You're focused on what's going right in your life rather than on what's going wrong. You're focused on the abundance rather than the lack. You're focused on the here and now. You're not wasting your time thinking about the past. You know you can't change the past. You can learn from it, but you can't change it. And you know the future is uncertain and it will always be that way, so you don't think about the future so much and too much, and you focus more on the present. And that's living with a mind that is programmed, you might say, with transcendental perspectives or transcendental types of thoughts.